Welcome back to the Rope Access channel. In this video, we're going to build a little bit more on what we did in the previous video, and we're moving from simple pulley systems to compounding pulley systems. Let's get into it. In the last video, we saw that if the load and the pulleys are moving in the same direction to the anchor point and at the same speed, then we call it a simple pulley system. But what if we start adding things on that change that? What does happen?
Now, while I write this down on the board, make sure to watch till the end of the video because I have another quiz for you guys. The results from last week's quiz you can find at www.theropeaccesschannel.com on the post from last week. Also, at the end of the video, I will tell you about VRigger, the awesome software I'm using to create all the images to create a clearer picture of what I'm trying to explain to you guys. So hang around if you want to get a discount on a VRigger. On with the video.
You all know this by now because I've talked about it in two more videos. If you have not seen the previous one, you can watch it up there. Click the thing that will pop up right now. Let's draw it again. I messed up. 100. We will change this, and let's say we are starting to haul like this. What did we learn in the first video? Load is divided by two ropes, so this is a 2-2-1. And now I find out it's too heavy. I change of direction. I change the direction. Pull like this. It's still too heavy. Like so. All right, now we start adding on stuff. And this time I will start changing colors a little bit. Maybe, hopefully it makes it a little bit clearer. I add my rope clamp. Take out the rope. And the rope will go through a pulley and I will go up like this. Add a new pulley. Now, what have I done? This was the question at the end of the last video, and stay until the end of this video because I will leave a few more questions for you, like a little quiz to see if you have learned. I built another system onto a pulley system, and we call this a compound pulley system. They're compounding onto each other. But is it still a 2-to-1? There's multiple ways of approaching this again. I talked about collapse rate. Well, I mentioned collapse rate. I mentioned the T method, and let's call it the simple method. The other one, I don't know if there's a name for it, but this is where you count the number of ropes pulling on the load. So if we start at the load for that, I will make this red. And we can see where there is a rope clamp. That's green. That's where we are pulling on. So actually, we are sort of in one system pulling in our 2-to-1, and we added another one which is pulling above the rope clamp. I will change this quickly to a 2-to-1 because now we can see more visual what happens. If I pull here, and me as one person, I put in something. I put in my strength. My strength is doubled because we learned that this is a 2-to-1. So if I put in 100, 200 goes up. If I need to lift 100, I need to put in 50. So it's twice. So anything that comes in here gets doubled at the end. And the end is where the load is. We've also seen that this system, I will draw it out here, we call this a 3-to-1. So basically, we can put whatever is in the red box. It's the same as this. My input in this system gets multiplied by 3. We call it a 3-to-1. In this system, my input gets multiplied by 2. We call it a 2-to-1. If we combine those and put the 3-to-1 onto the 2-to-1, then at the green rope clamp, or just, yeah, at the green rope clamp, my input is three times the amount as I'm putting in. That means that three times the input comes here, three, and here, three. So this is not a 3-to-1, not a 2-to-1. It's not a 3 plus a 2, 5-to-1. It is a 6-to-1. Because in the red box, I create a 3-to-1. That's what we've seen here. That 3-to-1 starts pooling on a 2-to-1. And we've seen here that everything we put into a 2-to-1 doubles up. So 6-to-1. What I have drawn here is the opposite of what we had on the board a second ago. I have my 3-to-1 system. Here. And on it is pulling a 2-to-1. We saw in the first video in this series, or actually the second, if you count the one where I talk about friction, I show the Z-rig. So if you have not seen it, you can click it up there. And if you like this so far, and all the other videos, give these videos a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you not already have done it, and hit that notification bell to always be notified of a new upload. If you want to support the channel, you can check out the Patreon. The link is in the description down below. And you, when you sit down to watch these videos with your cup of coffee or cup of tea, you buy me one. For now, that's the best way to support the channel. I'm working on t-shirts and all that stuff so I can be a schools intervention. Shout out to Nick and Clive and all the other guys. So we have our 3-to-1 in the red box, where everything that's put in gets tripled, but I'm pulling on it on a 2-to-1 in the green box. Let's do it like this. 2-to-1 and 3-to-1. That means that my 2-to-1 input, which is pulling here in the rope clamp, is a 2. And that 2 travels through the system. It meets the 3-to-1, so 2 times 3 is 6-to-1. The theoretical mechanical advantage is the same as the previous one, where we put the 3-to-1 on the 2-to-1. That makes total sense. It's just a different setup, and how you get to it might be due to working circumstances. I will give you one more. What do you think of this? 1, 2, and I add this one. I have my 3-to-1 and I add another 3-to-1, 3 times 3. So in this part, in the green, I have a 3-to-1, so my input gets tripled. And in the red, we can see it's gonna be confusing. We'll see what all the commenters think of it. Is another 3-to-1. In a 3-to-1 or Z-rig, my input gets tripled. So if I put 3 in, we have this Dutch song that's called Drie keer drie is negen. Ieder zingt zijn eigen lied. It's a 9-to-1.
So putting a 3-to-1 on a 3-to-1 resulting into a 9-to-1 seems very efficient. I mean, I need to put in 1 and I get 9 on the other end. That's good, but there are some disadvantages. It's easier for a one person or maybe a 2 or 3 person team to overload a system when we're pulling that hard or when our first forces are multiplied that much. That's one. And the other one is I need to do resets. When I'm doing the really basic, simple pulley system where the load is, where all the pulleys are connected to the load and I need that much rope, then there is no resets. But as soon as I start to move the pulleys from the load onto a rope clamp so that I will need less rope, or I can prevent that spinning twists all the ropes. Then I will need to start to make resets. Those resets from a 3-to-1 or a 5-to-1, what we saw in the little quiz, are not that bad, because you lift once, reset, you lift, reset, that's okay. But if you start compounding systems, like putting a 3-to-1 on a 2-to-1 or whatever version, I've rigged up a 3-on-a-3 right here, and then you need to start to do more resets, because one pulley system will travel at about 3 or 2 times or 4 times, depending on the system, of the speed that the other pulley is traveling. So let me show you. Again, we have a 3-to-1 system, and I have added another 3-to-1 system. So this 3 is pulling on this 3. And what we saw in all the previous videos and little pictures, that 3 input is multiplied and compounded through the system. The 3 gets multiplied by 3 and so now let me show you what will happen if I start pulling. I've rigged up a Maestro here. Carabiners are in here for proper orientation. I know it's not locked because we're not lifting anything heavy. The gate is on the floor, which I would never do with a human being. But right now I'm just playing around a little bit. I have 50 kilos of weight over there. It's going up down here. So let me set it up. So I have my, like I said, I have my 3-to-1 system, my Z-rig, and I have another Z-rig over here, pulling on that, so I have a 9-to-1. Right now I'm at the yellow line. I will put the second system up to the first system, so they're basically at the same spot. If we start counting steps, like 1, 2, 3, 3 big steps, then working with a 9-to-1, which we could call a 3-to-1 compounding on the 2, a 3-to-1, would mean, in theory, that if I move this rope clamp 3 meters, this rope clamp will move 1 meter, 3 divided by 1, and it will feel 9 times as light. How confusing can it be? So let's see if that practice, that theoretical or ideal world, translates into the actual world that we see right now. So I will start walking back. The weight is going up. It was already suspended a little bit. I keep pulling until I cannot go any further. So I'm touching here. There's a little bit of, like, the rope sags a little bit. So let's see what we did. We know that this one moved 3 meters because we just measured it. And this one moved 1 meter. Well, let's call it steps, because my steps are probably not 1 meter, but I have 3 big steps to go there. This one moved 1, 2, 3 to where this one is. So that means if I lift the load 1 meter, I can only move this 3 meters. So then I would need to do a reset, like so. Right now, we had 1 step till here, a little bit less. Let's see where we end up. Oh, I don't have enough room over there. I don't have the height. How unfortunate is that? Well, this should show you that if you use compounding systems, that one of the definitions is, which you will see when I replay it right now, is that the pulleys all move towards the anchor point, but they don't move at the same speed, because the one pulling on the load moves at the same speed as the load, as in a simple system, but the compounding part of it moves at 3 times or 2 times or 4 times the speed, depending on how we rig it up. Right now we have a 3-on-a-3, that means that this one moves at 3 times the speed. That means a lot of resets. If you have the room, you could stagger the anchors. So make this distance like three times as long, so you get an even throw in the system. It's all possible. But these are things to take into account, because if you're building a pulley system to get a quick raise and you have a team, then maybe it's better to have a less efficient system, say a 3-to-1, but less resets with what a 9-to-1 would be. Or maybe you should rig this as a 5-to-1. Or like with double pulleys here. Because then, my mic is loose. I hope it recorded properly. So a 5-to-1, because then you could get one big pull and a long reset. This would mean like multiple resets, it's a lot more hassle. So sometimes compounding systems are not the way to go. Sometimes they might be, but let it be a conscious decision. All right, back to the studio.
All right, time for a quiz.
Before we get into the quiz, let me tell you about VRigger. VRigger is a really cool piece of software that you can use to create all kinds of rigging scenarios that you'd want. You can see the images that I've scattered through the video. You can make anything you want. You can use export them as JPEGs, bitmap, PNGs, TIFFs, so you can really go to town in Photoshop. You can export them with a background or without a background, so you can overlay them easily. You can create your rigging setup and then press calculate forces, and the program will calculate. You can see the load move around a little bit, and it will calculate where the forces go. You can see where your safety factors, which you can also customize, are in the danger zone or exceeding what you've set up. While I was making these images, I thought, well, maybe I can use a little bit of the reach I've been gaining in the last few months and do something for you guys, my followers and subscribers. I emailed Steve at VRigger and he was totally up for that. So right now, if you hit the link in the description down below, and I'll put it on the screen right now, then you get a discount if you use my code TRACK10 at checkout. All right, on to the quiz. Good luck.
Three quizzes, A, B, and C. Quiz A, we have our load and it's suspended, pulleys and stuff, and then I add the blue system on top of it. What is my mechanical advantage if I pull here? Question number A. Question number B, I have my black system and I add a separate system on the same load. And me as a single person, I pull on both strands at the same time. What is the mechanical advantage? So that's B. And then C is an interesting one, a completely different kind of setup. I have my load, it's suspended. Let's draw it like this. It's suspended. The rope is anchored to the floor, goes up through a pulley, down to the load, and I start pulling on the blue rope. What is my mechanical advantage? Question C is, when would you use this? You have already seen an example in the videos I've released of real life work. If you haven't seen it, you can watch it up here. Let me know in the comments what the answers are. I will see you in the next one. Stay connected.